with my teammates. It's like, no chance, I'm sorry. The transition on the field, it really wasn't different. I legitimately had to go out and get out. One of the things Wilson put in my head, you know, when he was able to be around a lot more, he says, you get your 3 outs and then you celebrate. Well, I'm pretty good at celebrating, so let's go get these 3 outs.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I've been pretty fortunate to be able to do as well as I have, you know, not know what to keep on going. But it is what it is, you know. I'm not afraid anymore. I definitely have a lot more, feel that I have more self-worth about myself in that closing role. Without having a good seventh inning guy, there is no good eighth inning guy. Without no eighth inning guy, there is no good closer. There are no opportunities. We complement each other. So my mindset didn't change. My job didn't change. It's just the beginning.
Yeah.
You know, I'm the last guy standing. Very proud to be, by the way. On the field, you know, playing and getting the job done, there really isn't a difference, you know, because you got to get out. And that's what pitchers do. We get out.
You did a boss job in the series, but do you think you can show me how to throw your no on?
Secret.
Someday. maybe towards the end of my career, though. There's a reason why I feel that I'm as effective as I am. It's because I am different. You'd be surprised. Here, I'll give you this. My slider grip is a left-handed two-seamer grip. So if you can kind of put two and two together, there's a little bit different for myself. I'm I like being different. So you don't know the 7 times I faced him before that and where he didn't get a hit off me, so you only remember those two? Okay, that's okay. Four times, you know, in my career. Do I have a new pitch? In all reality, I have some new tricks up my sleeve. I have to keep improving. You know, I can't just come in with the same stuff, and because people will adjust to me. So in my style, for those 2 times that he did get me, I will say this: how often do I throw those hanging sliders down the middle? Not very often. So as long as I can limit those opportunities or those chances that I give him. Good hitters, this is a big league. You make mistakes, they will hurt you.
Yeah.
And it just so happened to be the same guy twice. Not too many guys can say they've gotten me twice. So there's a reason why he was smiling the whole way around. It wasn't because they were important homers for his team. They was like, hey, no way he let me do that. You know what I'm saying? So in all reality, I make quality pitches. Trust me, better quality pitches, and you'll see different results.
All right, we have more questions here.
Can you tell us what was going through your head when you were facing Jay Bruce?
Oh, wow. Well, his reputation, I mean, what he's been able to do in his career, those who follow the game and not just the Giants, he's gotten so many big hits for his team. He is a very clutch player. I'd already put myself in a little rut there, you know, I had a little bit of a jam, and when I saw him coming up, I was like, oh, right, okay, cool, it's him and his own ballpark, it's, you know, packed house and limbo grad everywhere, and I'm like, oh, goodness, here we go. And it was literally just make good pitches, you know. From hitter to hitter, you want those pitches to be the best pitches of the season. And in Bama, I said, it's not about trying too hard to make those, it's just letting them happen, trusting my stuff, trusting that I have what it takes to get the dudes out. So the whole battle was like, got him 0-2, then fouled off like 5 in a row, threw a ball, fouled off another one, threw a ball, fouled off another one, threw a ball, fouled off another one, fouled off another one. I'm saying, like, let's go, dude. Like, how many good pitches do I have to make to you? You know, but it was really a test of the willpower, you know, who wanted it more. And I'm not saying he didn't want it, I'm not discrediting him at all. I think I wanted just a little bit more. I think it meant a little bit more to me personally and for my team for me to get that job done. And then once I got him out, oh my gosh, it's Scott Rowland. Here we go. This guy's an established all-star, you know, an established veteran of the game. And man, I had to make those pitches even better. And you know, here I am going, man, this is tough. But wasn't afraid in those situations. I didn't back down. Mano a mano, you know what I'm saying? No. Let's go, my best against yours. And, what a battle. I definitely won't ever forget. Oh, yes. Definitely won't ever forget forget that moment. That was, that meant a lot to me to be able to get that job done.
I gotta share with you guys, in that game I was in the clubhouse waiting for the game to be over, and I was sweating bullets. I was in we're in the PR department waiting for the game to be over, and Javi Lopez, this is how much confidence his teammates had in him. Javi Lopez walked in, I don't know where he went, but he saw me and he's like, sir, don't worry about it. He has it in control.
Okay.
But I wasn't throwing the pitches, he was. So, I mean, he did, right? Because we have another brand. Any more questions?
How do you feel when you get the celebration in the hometown?
Say it again.
The celebration on your hometown.
Well, definitely, it's a different experience when you get to celebrate in front of your own fans. We were able to clinch the division this year in front of you guys and the NLCS in front of you guys. So, for us to be able to do that and share that with you guys, it means a lot more. It really, really does. That's two times now, though, that we've clinched the World Series on the road. Definitely like to change that, you know, here pretty soon. Celebrate here with you guys. Celebrate being able to come and just enjoy it. They gave us those little victory laps. Those are extremely meaningful and very memorable for all of us. Especially the NLCS, where it's pouring rain. Everybody stayed. Everybody cared enough to just stay in the rain and go home just completely drenched. And a couple of us came home with colds after that, but it is what it is, you know. I'm sure we weren't the only ones. It's definitely a different meaning, definitely a different feeling, and it's actually definitely more, emotional too, because I mean, I've been to the prior times, you know, so definitely to be able to share that with you guys, it's really real, it really is fun.
All right, they gotta go. We have time for one more question.
Thank you. Last year you had in Michon, you see the banda, maybe a little circle bailador. Well, definitely right now, definitely in Michon, you know what I'm saying? About that one as well, you know what I'm saying? So like, there's definitely some more banda out there. So I want to keep it, put a little Mexicana swag in there. So you never really know. I'm going to make some suggestions though.
He did use El Bandador a couple of times.
Yeah. And then there's a couple guys in the clubhouse, like, I don't know, Guillermo, Mora, and Pablo, like, hey, I dance better than you. Okay, let me go change it. And then I change it, and it turned into what it is. So, in all reality,
it'll make sense. All right, so let's hear it for...